Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Friday, September 30th, 2011. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are below fair value. Dow futures are currently down about 100 points. We're seeing weakness in energy. Crude oil is down about a dollar in the pre-market this morning, and gold is up about $5 in the pre-market on Friday morning. Well, Thursday was another very volatile day. We still have the VIX up close to 40, and in that range, you're going to continue to have volatile days. Looking at the 60-minute charts, we're looking for an hourly breakdown below 39.04 to give us a new sell signal for the VIX. That, of course, would be supportive for higher stock prices. And at that point, you would expect to see an hourly close above 11.65.27 to give us a new intraday buy signal for the S&P 500. But so far, we're down in the pre-market this morning, so it doesn't look like we're going to get to that point at the open. Now, yesterday we were down the 1140 area for the S&P 500 cash index. If that breaks down on Friday, we're looking for a move down to 1125, and then we've got a recent low down there at 1114.22, and then the recent high is 1195.86. So that's the range that we're playing in right now, and we're looking for a breakout of that range. Moving over, looking at daily charts, no changes on Thursday. The VIX still up closer to 40 than 30. We need it below 30 to tell us something new's happening here in the market. We're looking for money to flow out of bonds and back into stocks. After generating a sell signal the other day, nothing's happening. We're not seeing money flow out yet. Still looking for a change in the U.S. dollar. It's still up at the top of the range here, and no sign of a breakdown yet. Looking at gold prices, no major changes yesterday. It recovered most of its losses going into the close. We had a nice reversal for copper yesterday off support, and that was enough to give us a bullish reversal signal. If we can see fall through to the upside on Friday, we may have put in a bottom here for copper, and down at a weekly area, an area of support that's not only daily but weekly. 312.50 is a weekly area of support as well. So let's see if we can get some fall through to the upside on Friday. No change for the major indexes, S&P 500. We saw money flow back into bank stocks yesterday, up nearly 3.5%. We're in the channel. We're still treading water here. So even with a 3.5% gain in bank stocks, you can't get out of the channel. Big down day yesterday for the NASDAQ intraday, paired a lot of its losses going into the close, but still a lot of weakness there. We're starting to see weakness in Apple. We're now on a sell signal for Apple Computer. Amazon traded down yesterday, but still closed above the lower channel line. We're pretty close to a sell signal for Amazon. Close below 222.05 would do that on Friday. Looking at some of the other stocks in the NASDAQ 100, Baidu had a bad day yesterday. Google has been on a sell signal for a few days now. No change there. Intel's still holding up very well. We saw weakness in the SOX index, but it wasn't caused by Intel. Netflix continues to move lower. Broke support at 125, so we're looking for a move down to 93.75 with psychological support at $100. Looking at the Russell 2000, no love of mid caps, no love of small caps in the ZAX micro cap index, no love for energy stocks. Fertilizer stocks getting whacked looks very similar to the gold and silver sector. We'll take a look at some commodities related to the fertilizer sector in a minute. And saw weakness in the SOX index yesterday. It had more to do with AMD than it had to do with Intel. Taking a look at the transports, no change there. And no change for the euro. Still on a sell signal, been trading sideways last couple of days. A move in currencies could help the commodities put in a bottom here. Looking at commodity prices, no change for crude oil, no change for gasoline, no change for natural gas. And we've already looked at copper, gold, and silver. No changes there. Taking a look at some of the fertilizer-related commodity stocks, we're seeing weakness in corn, in rice, in soybeans, and wheat. And those lower commodity prices are not helpful to the fertilizer producers. Okay, that's all for Friday morning, folks. It's the end of the month, end of the quarter. You have automatic money coming into the market at this time, last of the month, first of the new month. You've got all those deposits, those withdrawals taken off people's paychecks that go into their retirement accounts that Often much of it makes its way into the stock market, so that can help bolster the stock market at the end of the month. And we've got the window dressing going on, which is where mutual fund managers fudge their books by buying the best performing stocks and selling the worst performing stocks in their portfolio going into month end. It's a bit of fraud, but nobody for some reason seems to care. And so we're not looking for a major move down on Friday or Monday, but it could happen. And of course, if it does happen, that would certainly tell us that the stock market still has a ways to go on the downside. So have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you again on Monday morning.